The title of my talk today is Nondispersing Multi-Electron Trojan-Like Wavepackets on the Synchronous Langmuir Type 1 Bulk Wire Trajectories. Let me make the brief introduction. What are the Trojan Wavepackets themselves? And they are the solutions of the Schrödinger equation of the hydrogen atom in the circularly polarized field. And what is so interesting about them is that the probability density of the electron is in this solution is invariant and in shape, and is moving with the same shape around the circle, around the circular trajectory. And we call them Trojan wave packets because the classical mechanics is very similar to the dynamics of the Trojan asteroids, which are generated by the time-dependent gravitational field of the Sun-Jupiter system. And this is Trojan wave packet for n equals 60, and this quantum number means that, because this is time-dependent solution, quantum number means that the main component of the packet is around the hydrogen eigenstate of the principal quantum number 60. And we constructed the theory of it. If you go to rotating frame, you reduce the time dependence of the Hamiltonian, and you get the Hamiltonian which corresponds to the effectively the Stark-Zeeman effect, except that the Zeeman term is reduced, there is no harmonic oscillator term. And you can find the approximate analytical solution by simplifying the Hamiltonian matrix. And the simple solution is indeed because the Hamiltonian has a feature of the quantum pendulum with negative and fractional mass. You get the simple quantum solution as a Gaussian in all space dimensions. And you also can construct the harmonic theory. You can expand the Hamiltonian up to a second order around the classical equilibrium point, the rotating frame, which corresponds to the circular trajectory. And you find out that you get stability zones when the Hamiltonian has normalizable eigenstate. These are the crossing zones between the black line and the blue zones of general stability of this kind of crank harmonic oscillator. And you can pinpoint the basic classical mechanics already on simulations of the computer as low as 3.5 megahertz. So this is 80s mini computer ZX Spectrum. I will show you the simulations. You start from the ensemble of 100 points. And if the circularly polarized field is turned on, you get confinement of the initial conditions with some shape oscillations because there is no quantum mechanics here, but you get confined dynamics. And if you turn off the field, you get the spreading of the ensemble of points around the circle to something which is a classical equivalent to the circular state. And now let me first thing we try to do is to extend the solution to two electrons, and this is in Langmuir paper from 20s, which when he tried to quantize the helium atom in synchronized to bohr atom, and he found the two parallel circles trajectories of the electrons when the electrons are moving in phase and interacting on those trajectories in helium atom. And the trajectories are classically unstable, and you can stabilize them with addition of the circularly polarized field and the magnetic perpendicular magnetic field. The CP field is rotating around the vector of the B field, and you get the stability zones, and which corresponds also to the non-dispersing probability density wave packets of two electrons now. So these are fully quantum solutions which corresponds to classical solutions of two electrons on Langmuir trajectories. And this is our physical review letter about those. Now we want to go beyond the circular trajectories to other trajectories also to extend number of electrons to more. And this is the paper of a Polish nuclear physicist Michael Grzyński, and he was promoting the model of atom, which is resigning from quantum mechanics. And of course, you can do that. You can do classical simulations if you want. You can resign from quantum mechanics. And he discovered this kind of trajectories of electrons in the hydrogen atom, which are strongly deformed triangular trajectories. And the reason is that the reason that electron is not falling collisionally on the nucleus is that it has a magnetic moment, and this magnetic moment is in the frame of the electron. The nucleus is seen as the current, and it extorts the Lorentz force on the electron. That's why the electron is deflected near the nucleus by the Lorentz force, and it results in three parabola trajectories, which are semi-triangular. And we added the magnetic field. We added the magnetic field perpendicular to the plane of the motion, and we obtained truly triangular trajectories and truly polygonal trajectories, not only triangular but polygonal, depending on the strength of the magnetic field and the initial conditions for resonant values. For example, square, pentagon, heptagon, triangle. Okay, and so this is for single electron, and this is the Hamiltonian. This is the time dependent field, this is the magnetic field, this is additionally, you can consider artificial atoms in quantum dots. This is the frequency, harmonic frequency of the quantum dot, and you will find out that the solutions are scaled. They have scaling properties that if you find one, that you generate whole class with the parameter alpha. It is scaling parameter that you get whole class of solutions. And now we go to the bulb, what I call bulb wire trajectories, because they resemble the tungsten wire of the old bulb. Now everything is going to the energy conserving bulbs, but this is the old bulb with the tungsten wire. So this is for example classical simulations for the single electron, for pair of electrons. So they resemble Langmuir trajectories on circle, but the pair is moving. One electron is moving on the triangle, and the second is moving on the triangle. Also, this is heptagon trajectory. One electron is moving on heptagon, and second in phase on heptagon. This is again in quantum dot. When you turn off the nuclear field, also you get two triangular trajectories for two electrons. If you add the nuclear field of helium, you also get and also external CP field and magnetic field, you get two triangular trajectories. So now what we want to do is to extend this to n number of electrons. This is the example of the trajectory for six electrons. So two electrons are moving, they are placed in vertices of the triangles, and they are hoping in the way that one electron is escaping, one the other is taking its place, okay? So this is here are three electrons in upper layer and three electrons on lower layer, they are coherently moving that way. To be clear, this is the movie of the motion. So you see they are like sort of dancing. You can see that the electrons are dancing on. One electron is taking place of the other, and these are the Newtonian simulations of classical equations of the motion. This is for different parameters. When you turn on the dot quantum dot field, the harmonic fields, spherical. This is spherical quantum dots when the harmonic oscillator is fully symmetric. So again, you can see the movie that this is the same kind, this is in opposite direction, but this is the same kind trajectories. So electrons are interacting, one electron is interacting with all of the other electrons, and they are moving on approximately on the triangle, and one electron is hopping to the place when the other was, and so on. It's like coherent motions, and we know that this kind of trajectories can now support the non-dispersing multi-electron wave packets with the probability densities localized around each of the electrons. Okay, so this is basically the quantum density functional theory approach, and there's a quantum, I call it Gutzwiller Heller theorem for n-body problem, that for each stable classical trajectory of the system of n-body stationary in the rotating frame, there is a geometrically localized wave function of the corresponding quantum harmonic oscillator at this point, and this extends, of course, to the non-stationary trajectories of certain symmetry that the packets around are moving, but they are slightly oscillating in shape because the trajectory is not frozen in the rotating frame. So if there is there is a motion in the rotating frame, then the packet will oscillate slightly, but it still stay dispersed. And you can do quantum simulations with density functional theory in Hartree limit that each electron is experiencing the effective electric field of all the other electrons. For n electrons, this is written for two, but you can do the same way for arbitrary number of electrons. You can also time-dependent Monte Carlo simulations, and this is the summary page of my method of solving. I developed basically two methods. One is nonlinear, second is linear, and it is similar to the stationary quantum diffusion Monte Carlo method, except that you walkers have something for quarks. So you impose color on walkers to represent the wave function in the negative and the positive, the imaginary and the real part, and you also must impose the sign on walkers, sort of like spin. So walkers have sort of spin, and therefore they can change sign whenever the wave function is reaching zero, because the stationary diffusion Monte Carlo is leading to the fact that the function, all the components which are not the ground state are decaying to zero. So you must do something with time dependence when to handle the wave function is zero, and then you must cross the zero to negative values. So you generate simply walkers with negative sort of spin. Okay, and this let me show you how the packet, this is volumetric plot of the one of the electron wave packets moving on the trajectories I was discussing, and this is in three dimensions, so it looks sort of like avocado fruit. Okay. And let me now summarize that in 1921, Irving Langmuir, in early attempts of the quantization of the helium atom by the Bohr-Sommerfeld conditions, found the periodic parallel two circular two electron classical trajectories in what we call hoop earrings configurations. So they resemble female hoop earrings, and the trajectories are, I call them like that, the trajectories are always unstable and can be stabilized by the combination of the symmetry augmented magnetic and the electromagnetic superimposed CP fields. In 1965, Michael Grzynski proposed the radially oscillating electron model of atom, where the electron direct straight line nucleus collision trajectory is deflected by the interaction of its magnetic moment with the nuclear charge due to the Lorentz force or due to the magnetic induction, what results in three hyperbolic periodic cross trajectory called radiola. And we notice that that such field does not need to be a dipole field or the electron or nucleus, but can be uniform magnetic field which results in the trajectories which are not only semi-triangular but any regular polygon trajectories. We find such trajectories now It can be used in the Langmuir type 1 configurations for 2n of the electrons with n half of the electrons synchronously moving on the semi-regular polygon trajectories. While interacting with all other electrons which in 3D resemble the bulk wires, and the phase external rotating CP field is slightly altering and stabilizing the trajectories in addition to the magnetic field. And such trajectories can, as I was discussing for the Trojan wave packets, support a stable non-dispersing multi-electron quantum wave packets with the probability density sharply localized around the classical electron motion, and can be confirmed either in the full dimensions. They can be confirmed in Hartree Fock three-dimensional grid simulations in Hartree limit, or as well as within the stationary and our recently developed a new time-dependent quantum diffusion Monte Carlo methods. Okay, now I will end.